Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Thank you, the organizer. The arranging is just interesting, and the participated conference here. So I am talking about equitable total carrying and Knodel's graph, W3N. First of all, I organized this presentation as first of all, I defined what is equitable total carrying, then about talking about Knodel's graph, and then after what the recent work has done, and then after I arranged my the theorem, that is proof of my work, and before proof of rewards, I organized the part using two or three lemmas, and then of that, I proved that theorem. First of all, maybe read some up. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Yes, let's go. Main objective of this my research, the main focus of the research is equitable total carrying of Knodel graph, W3N. Now I describe the concept of objective of this research. First of all, what is Knodel graph? The Knodel graph W delta N have an N greater than equal to 2 and vertices and edges are delta. And delta is 1 less than equal to, delta is greater than equal to 1 and less than equal to log 2 n. The vertices delta n are the pairs of ij with I equal to 1 and 2 and j less than equal to 0 and, sorry, greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to n by 2 minus 1. For every j, okay, greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to n by 2 minus 1, there is an edge between 1 and j and every vertices 2 within bracket j plus 2 power k minus 1 mod n by 2 for k equal to 0 up to delta minus 1. For delta, for w delta n, let vj represent the vertices 1j and uj represent the vertices 2j. In this paper, the vertices labels are at read module n by 2 unless specified otherwise. From the definition of the Knodel graph for delta equal to 3 and even n minus n greater than equal to 8, we have Knodel graph such this way. That is, vertices are v0 up to vn by 2 minus 1 and u0 up to u n by 2 minus 1. That is what is said. And h sets are sum of I 0 equal up to n by 2 minus 1 and set v I u I and v I u I plus 1 and v I u I plus 3. The figure shows that such Knodel graph. Here is Knodel graph example W38 and W340. The Knodel graph, we consider this regular graph for even order n and ages delta greater than or equal to 1 and less than log 2n. Since W3n are three regular graphs coordinating one with n, each of them has an equitable total of 5 coloring. In this paper, we show that psi W3n equal to 4 for n is equal to 8 and n is equal to n greater than or equal to 12. The k-total coloring of graph G is a coloring of the vertices and edges G with k colored so that no two adjacent or incident elements have same color. The total chromatic number psi double prime G of G as the smallest k such that G has k total coloring. A total coloring is equitable for the number of vertices and edges colored with each color before at most one. The smallest k such that G has a coloring is named equitable total chromatic number and defined by psi double prime G. There is a long-standing total coloring of conjecture TCC formulated by Behaj M and Vigin WG independently, which says that delta G plus 1 less than equal to double prime G less than equal to delta G plus 2 for a simple graph G. The other authors has shown that this double prime G is an empty complete. TCC has verified for several class of graphs in recent years, and the efforts have shown that even the problem of determining the total chromatic number K regular bipartite graph NP hard for each fixed and greater than K greater than equal to 3. So this is the recent more works. We skip, I skip in this part and define the my research, especially my work. Here I have proved the equitable total coloring of lotus curve W3N. I am considering two lemma here, and this lemma is defined by for I greater than or equal to 0 and less than n by 2 minus 1, let Gi, considering the W3N, vertices of Vi, Ui, and Ui plus 1, Ui plus 3, Uj plus 3, and Vj plus 2, Vj plus 3. And see figure 2.1 here. Then we have first lemma 2.1. Let sigma be a 4 total coloring at W3n, then sigma Egi different Vi and Ui plus 3 equal to 3. Since edges are Vi Ui and Vi Ui plus 1 and Vi Ui plus 3 are adjacent, they have to be colored with different color, say sigma Vi Ui equal to 1, that is here. Then sigma Vi Ui plus 1 equal to 2 and sigma Vi Ui plus 3 equal to 3, then sigma Vi equal to 4 and sigma Ui plus 3 belongs to 1, 2. If sigma Ui plus 3 equal to 1, then sigma sigma Ui plus 3 Vi plus 2 and Ui plus 3 Vi plus 3 equal to 2, 4. See the figure 2.1, 1 and 2 here. Then sigma Egi different Vi Ui plus 3 is equal to 1 to 4. Next, if sigma Ui plus 3 equal to 2, then sigma Ui plus 3 Vi plus 2 and Ui plus 3 Vi plus 3 equal to 1, 4. See the figure, the other, this one. So we can define the vertices and edges this way. Then by lemma 2.1, we have lemma 2.2, let sigma be a 4 coloring with W3N, then sigma is determined by E sigma E1. So we prove that the sigma I greater than equal to 0 and less than n by 2 minus 1 by lambda 2 by 2.1, we have modular sigma E gi different by vi ui plus 3 equal to 3. Hence, sigma vi ui plus 3 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 minus sigma e vi different vi plus ui plus 3 and the sigma vi equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 minus sigma vi ui plus 1 and ui plus 1 and vi ui plus 3 and the ui plus 3 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 minus this sigma ui plus 3 vi ui plus 3 vi plus 2 and this way. Now we consider the coloring of W3n. This means mean 0. W3n has an equitable fold coloring for n is equal to 8 and each event n greater than 12. By lemma 2.2, if sigma is a fold to coloring of W3n, then it can be determined by sigma E1. We first define sigma according to different n as follows. Then we show that the sigma and equitable total color for coloring of W3n. Here the numbering of different vertices and edges. We consider here four cases. Case one, we define as a falling numbering. Now, we can consider this figure. So, figure shows that sigma W3n or n modular 0 mod 8, we simply write sigma E1 equal to 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 4, 1, 2, up to n by 8. Then, complement of E1, sigma E1, we can consider this number. By lemma 2.1 and 2.2, we have still it is different, little bit lower size. No problem. Okay. Clearly, as sigma is fourth coloring with W3n, let Tj equal to T1, T2, T3, T4, we have Ti denoted the ith color of class of sigma. Then, modulo of T1, modulo of T2, and the modulo of T3 and T4 equal to 5n by 8. That is, notice that W3n has an equitable total 4 calorie for each n module 4 and mode 8. And case 2, we are considering that n module 2 mode 4, 8, let the sigma equal to this number, then we labeling the number vertices this way and considering this figure, we can see that the complement of E1 equal to this number, and by lemma 2.1 and 2.2, we have this coloring number. That is, sigma 2 equal to 3113 power by n minus 8 by 8 and 3113. That is, sigma V1 equal to 1234 power by n minus 8 by 8 and then 1234231 24n. Sigma 2 V2 equal to 4123 up n minus 18 by 8, that is 4 and 4 1 2 3 4 2 3 1 2. So clearly sigma is 4 total coloring notice of W3n, since T1 modular of T1 modular of T2 and modular of T3 and modular of T4 equal to 5n minus 2 by 8. And P2, 5n plus 6 by 8, we can conclude that W3n has an equitable to 4 coloring each n mode modular 2 mode 8. Then the case 3, we can consider the another case where n mode 4 mode 8, then sigma E1 equal to this way with the number in. And the figure shows that this number in, that is sigma complement E1 equal to 4234 2412 up n minus 12 by 8 and 14243132142342. While lambda 2.1 and 2.2, we have this type of color, that is sigma E2 equal to 3113 of n minus 12 minus 8 and 314313. At the same way, the sigma V1 1234 of n minus 12 by 8, that is, and 123124, and V2, sigma V2 is equal to 4123 of n minus 12 by 8, that is 412312. And clearly see that sigma is the four total coloring of Knodel stuff W3N10. Since P modulo T1 equal to modulo T2 equal to 5N plus 4 by 8, and T modulo T3 equal to modulo T4 is 5N minus 4, we can conclude that Knodel stuff W3N has an equitable four coloring for each n mode 4 mode 8. This one is lambda just 4. We can consider the similar way for the coloring of the edges and vertices. And here lambda E1 equal to 4 2 6 3 4 2 2 4 1 2 of 1 minus 6 by 8 and 2 4 3 4 2 1. And considering this figure, then lambda complement E1 equal to 4 2 3 4 2 4 1 2 of n minus 6 by 8 and 1 4 2 3 4 2. That is from here to we consider the part. By lemma 2.1 and 2.2, we have lambda E3 equal to 3113 n minus 6 by 8 and 313. Lambda V1 equal to 1234 n minus 6 and by 2 by 8. 1 to 4 and V2, lambda V2, the sigma V2 equal to 4 1 2 3 of n minus 6 by 8 and 4 1 2. Clearly that sigma is the 4 total coloring of Knodel of W3n, since modulo T1, T2 and T4 equal to 5 n plus 2 by 2 by 8 and n modulo T3 equal to 5n minus 6 by 8, we can conclude that Knodel stuff has an equitable four coloring for each this number. So now here we are considering only equitable total coloring n equal to 8 and n greater than equal to 12. But here you can find out that there is no equitable total four coloring for n is equal to 8. So we are fully proving here, here is the figure, the W3n, there is no equitable four coloring. W3n does not have a four total coloring. So we can, by contradiction, suppose that W3n has a 4 total coloring, then by lemma 2.1, the edges of color by this vertices must be colored by three color. By symmetry, we need to consider only those two cases. That is, these two cases you can consider, this set and this set. Now, case one, this sigma is like 2, 1, 3, 1. Then by lemma, 2.2, lambda u0 equal to 3, v0 equal to 2. By lemma 2.1, the edges of this what a set must be colored with three color. Let we consider C1 if sigma u4 v4 equal to C1, 3, then by lemma 2.2, u2 and sigma v4 u0 equal to 2 and sigma equal to sigma v2. A contradiction, see the figure. This. Then you can consider this part. So, hence, sigma v1 u2 and sigma v4 u2 u0 equal to 2. For lemma 2.1, the edges of this set must be colored with green color. Let sigma u0, v0, u1 equal to 3, this way, color, and by the lemma 2.2, you can consider this, equal to 3, a contradiction. You can see the figure 2.64, hence, you can see this figure, so we can consider the hence, the color is as this way we can define. Let u0 v0 equal 4, the lemma 2.1, we can define the number this way. Then case 2.1, we can consider the same way the values of this lemma, and case 2.2 by lemma 2.1, edges of color by must be colored with three color. If then by lemma 2.2, you can consider this value a contradiction, and you can see the figure 2.6. Hence, this is the value of 113. If lambda sigma 3.4 equal to 1, then by lemma 2.2, you can consider the value this way, and which is also a contradiction, and you can see the figure 2.67 and 2.68. So, from case 1, 2, we can conclude that W3N, 3N does not have a full coloring. And thank you for hearing me.
Thank you.